And with the Warpins coming, Vox is going to be able to stave off this Warpin, although it is has been very, very effective as it has killed his mining movement. He's had to move everything back and retreat. So here we've got some Excelsiors. I would love to see them take on this Nebula class. The Nebula class would be the best target right now. And we see going after the Ambassador, not the best move for these Excelsiors. But I don't know, it's working for him. He does have other ships, short-run ships that are doing some damage. Just can't switch between these two. Just make sure you push on the ship. So now especially with these two. And over here we've got some strikes. Decloaking trying to help. That's going to be a huge benefit to really help take this out, and Boggs can resume production. Although that did slow him down considerably, and puts the momentum in the bottom team's favor. So, I'm going to look over here, see what he's building. He's still doing Intrepids. Research ability has been researched. Here's Butters coming in with a small cloaked fleet. I want to look over and see what Butters is doing. Okay, he's got scouts building, and he's got Kubej. So going heavy, heavy Kubej, researching the heavy disruptor so that he can be more effective. Here we've got Laevels coming in, trying to dissuade these Kubej classes, and they're doing a great job of that. So Warpin coming in. This is Sergio's Warpin again. Moving in on Zergel. So the nice thing is this Laevel is really going to be taking out this Excelsior class, as it does extra damage to ships with AI. Of course, now we see Sergio not attacking. He needs to. He does not have the second repair, the auto repair ability on the Laevel. So that's gonna really hurt him. Luckily, he was able to get away. I think he's a cloak. I want to see if he's researching that. He is not researching that. He really needs to, as that's one of the most powerful abilities that ship has. So, the bottom team really putting the pressure on. As you can see, now we've got Butters coming in to help, really taking out the expansion up here. I want to see what Boggs is doing over here. Sending his warp in, and another minute, and he'll have another Warpin ready to come in. Trying to take out the Borg. I want to get a little bit of light there. As we can see, there's a sphere building. And if Boggs can see this, he might have been able to take it out. The sphere is going to really, really change the nature of the game. As we can see, he'll follow. Not able to, doesn't have really any defenses, although once he has this sphere up, he'll really be able to take all of these vessels out. So, we've got Sergio calling back that repositioning forces, trying to take this out. The one problem with Boggs attacking this base is that the Borg just have such heavy defenses that you really, really need a large Federation strike force to take anything out. Now that this sphere is out, it's going to be able to tank these Federation ships. And switching back to top-down view, as we can see, Boggs getting out of there. I want to look over here to fleet composition here. We've got Sergio trying to stake a claim at the center of the map, doing a great job with Butter's support. Helfala is moving in with his ships. Once he has that sphere and these support vessels, the scout cubes and the detectors, or the probes rather, he's going to be a pretty significant force on the map. Here's Boggs sending in his warp in to support his other ships. That might help him against these probes and these scout cubes. I'm not sure if it's going to be quite enough against that sphere. however. So, although, if he keeps building... Intrepids, he will be able to do a pretty good job on that sphere. As we can see, seeing the forces he's going up against, that's quite a strong force. Let's see what he does against this fleet. The best move right now is to take out the scout cubes, take out the detectors, go repair, and then take on that sphere. So, I want to look over. Trying to see what's gonna go on. This is really close to how I found his base, so I don't know. Alfala moving his ship away but not using regen. This is a free regen comms here. Not using the regen ability whatsoever, and he should. But moving in a scout cube, he's gonna lose that scout cube. But it looks like that's backing out, but every time he does this, he's weakening his small picket vessels. And they're just going to be that much weaker when they need to do some heavy engagement. Over here, Sergio, moving in with some Intrepids. Going to try to raid on Boggs. Over here, Allied Repair going up on this Yurati Yard. And another phaser platform, so... bottom team really doing a good job taking the center over. Over here we've got Robo Primus taking out Butter's main resource ability. So people calling out trying to figure out what Boggs is doing. Moving left and right there. Again, more Kubej. Just fleets and fleets of Kubej here. So, I want to look over here. Really, Butter's mining has just been killed thanks to Gorgo Primus. So, a good job by Gorgo Primus with his Laevals and Shrikes. I want to see over here kind of what he's moving into. He's doing Rins now. Okay, so that'll give him a nice, strong harassing unit and also be very, very good against... both the all the short range vessels out there, plus also maybe some of the veg that Butters is fielding as phase plates still need to be decent as well. Complete torpedo platform and a warbird by Gorgo Primus. That's right, he's purple and he's in the center. Now they're attacking the base. The problem with attacking a well-defended support area like this. There's all these kinds of turrets, and there's a repair yard. Not exactly the best place to go and take things on at. As you can see, two torpedo platforms. Wow. The top team is all in, and that's good for them. I want to see. There's all... Oh, and here's the board. I really think that's going to... change the name of the game here. We're coming in, and Butters has some ships. And one thing I'm noticing is that a lot of strikes are being lost by this. Zergel moving out of there, Fez moving out of there, and Gorgo is staying in, and that's the problem. They need to get out of here. This cloak king will be able to detect cloak ships, and that's going to be a hard thing for Gorgo to get out of there. So now, Boggs having to contend with the Federation fleet. Just a couple of Celsiors. I didn't see how many ships they took out. Gorgo did use a lot of strikes in that engagement, so I'm not sure how effective that was. Now they're just going to against the torpedo platforms. But to be honest, what you do is when someone tries to establish a field base, it's very, very easy for you to just